Welcome back, troglodytes, to your daily dose of guitar information, the Trogly's Guitar Show. Today we're going to talk about the 2016 Gibson Les Paul Traditional Plain Top Zebra model. This is the other one that I got from the Trade Tuesday meetup this week. And basically, the fun little story of the history of this one is a landlord bought it brand new, and then essentially it was traded to the guy who owned it, back to the landlord, back and forth. I think he said like 6 or 7 different times. And him trading it for my Flying V is what broke that cycle. So what is a traditional? Well, a traditional is a standard when a standard was a modern. That makes no sense. But essentially from like summer of 2008 till 2019, if you wanted a Les Paul with standard specs, you would go for a traditional. And I don't know about you guys, traditional just doesn't sound as cool as Les Paul standard, so I never really cared about these things when they were alive. But lucky for us, a guy with a website called GibsonTraditional.com did care about them, and he documented pretty much every single run beautifully. If it wasn't for his website, I probably would have told you the wrong specs for this thing. There's some really cool traditional models out there. I've covered a few of the traditional pros, which I believe were Guitar Center limited editions. Some of them anyways. There's a really cool Coil Tap P90 version, one with a Floyd Rose, some with Bigsby's. There's the ever crazy 12 string one, which you know I'll have to review one day. And even some with like mahogany tops. But within 2016, there's actually 8 different traditional models introduced. Let's talk about a couple of them. There's this one called the Plain Top Zebra. Now, plain top means you're going to get some really nice wood grain in it. And that's definitely the case on this one. I mean, take a look at the back of this. It seems most of them have really nice choice mahogany backs and mahogany necks here. And these ones are solid body. Some traditionals do have 9-hole weight relief though. But then there was one just called the Les Paul Traditional that had covers over the pickups. And you could get different finishes besides just lemon burst on this front, such as light burst, cherry sunburst, and tobacco burst. But then there's also something called a Traditional T, which had 9-hole weight relief, unlike the other two traditionals we were just talking about from 2016, and it came in a honey burst finish. Man. Gibson was such a confusing time back then. I'm so happy they simplified things with the original collection and the modern collection. So I would say that wraps up the history of this one. Let's go ahead and throw it on the workbench and take a closer look at its specs. So in the neck pickup cavity, you can see it reads LM for lemon burst. That's what they called this finish. And then in the bridge pickup cavity, it reads LP for Les Paul, TD for traditional, Z for zebra pickups, and 16 for a 2016 model year. Now, what's kind of interesting about the specs of this one is it says you should have a 57 in the neck, which is correct, but the bridge pickup in this one is supposed to be a 57 plus.
So it seems the Gibson Traditional website is incorrect on that, because if I look up an old Z Zounds listing, it says both should be 57 classics.
So the neck pickup is 7.7, middle position for fun, 3.85, 7.69. Now, despite being a traditional and supposed to be using traditional components, it has a Nashville-styled bridge, which is okay, but it has a modern appointment here with the posts. This is the type that you can put an Allen key adjustment in to make it easier to adjust your action up and down while still under string tension. So that's a very nice modern feature, just kind of strange that they used it on this. And the tailpiece on this example has been replaced, unless they randomly use Japanese parts on their guitars today. The weight of this one seems to be in between like a lightweight and a heavyweight one, so not a huge deal, but good to know. Got cream plastic switch tip and washer, but you know, the more and more I look at this guitar, the more I liked it. When I got it in trade, I was like, yeah, it's a Les Paul Traditional. They're pretty easy to sell. But this plain top, it's a two-piece maple top, but I'm digging it. It gets super plain right here, but that's where the pickguard covers it anyway, so I'm not too worried about that. And no fancy electronics here, just traditional pots with golden speed knobs. So once again, two-piece maple top, solid mahogany body on this one. We've got a mahogany neck in a 50s style, Gibson calls it, and a rosewood fretboard here. Nothing too much to say over here. You do still have your fret binding nibs. The inlays, they're a little bit yellowed. I mean, not like Les Paul classic late 90s yellow or anything, but a pretty nice piece of rosewood here.
The truss rod cover reads traditional. It's a pretty popular modification to swap that out for one that says standard. But you have Les Paul model silkscreen and Gibson mother of pearl logo. We have a nut width of 1.67 inches, which increases to 2.08 at the 12th. First fret neck depth, 0.85, and at the 12th, 0.97. And built to tradition at 24 and 3 quarters inch scale length. Moving on to the backside here, two other non-traditional features on this traditional include the large style strap buttons. These are basically Gibson's response to a strap lock, where it's better than the regular style strap button, but not quite as secure as a strap lock. They do work pretty well. And finally are the back plates. They have shielding built into them. You can tell if you have that version because it's kind of a textured back. So a standard from this era would have a PCB system with push poles on it. This doesn't have any type of fancy electronics and it's all hand wired. Same thing goes for the toggle cavity switch. To me, this looks like a two-piece center seam back, but oh my goodness. I think this is my favorite thing about this guitar is the back. It definitely has some very nice figuring to it, a little bit of a flame pattern. So if you like that bright mahogany color, I think you're really going to love this example. Gibson advertises the neck as 50s in style, and we've got the Gibson Clouson Deluxe style tuners on here. And this is back when the serial numbers read year, so 2016, and then it's just a production number, so 43,600, looks like 89. You can also see it has the thin binding in the cutaway, which is a 50s correct spec. That allows you to see the maple cap being exposed. Not a vintage correct thing, but a nice one, a metal output jack plate. This example weighs 9 pounds, 12.1 ounces. Suggest a Gibson Les Paul traditional? Definitely. These can be a really good value for the money. They can generally be had around $1,600 or less. Some of those Trad Pro models you can pick up relatively cheap, like around $1,200 sometimes. So if you just want a killer normal Les Paul without all the fancy stuff, but you want a used one so the price isn't super high, definitely check these guys out. So now that we know all about the Gibson Les Paul Traditional Plain Top Zebra and Lemon Burst, let's go ahead and go over the condition if you're interested in buying it. This Paul is actually in pretty good shape. You've got some light scratches from string change wear and things like that. But the main thing on this one is it's got some nicks and dings, especially around the edges. You see right there on the headstock, it looks like it kind of dinged up against something, maybe the ceiling. So a little bit of edge wear here. Frets, I didn't see any like what I would consider fret wear on this one, but I just put a fresh set of 10 gauge strings on here, polished the frets up, and oiled the fretboard, so you're good to go there. Just do a personalized setup. The guitar does have a very slight smoke pet odor to it. I mean, it's very slight. I don't think most people would have issues with this, especially after I just got done polishing it and cleaning it up a little bit. I mean, it's nothing major, but if you're allergic to those scents, I do want you to be aware of it. So just some light scratches on the top from light usage. Again, the tailpiece has been replaced with a Goto part. Moving on to the back of the headstock, 2016 model. You can read your serial number there. The back of the neck. See, Gibson considers this a 50s neck, and it's only 50s in the way it feels as it's rounded. It's not like wide and flat. When I think 50s neck, I think big, chunky baseball bat R7. So it's always kind of difficult for me to differentiate between 50s and 60s, because sometimes I disagree with Gibson's spec. So it's a rounded feeling, but I mean, it's not like crazy thick or anything. Backside, once again, my goodness, I love the mahogany on this one. Look at it dance, it's beautiful. However, it does have quite a bit of edge wear. I mean, nothing that I would consider like crazy here. I mean, you can see that little ding right there and maybe some light buckle worming marks, but nothing that's too eye-catching. But the only thing on the back is there is a chip out of the finish right here. That's visible. And when you go along the edges of the instrument, there's kind of a few more chips in the finish. That's the best way to put it. It doesn't look like there's any on the treble side, but unfortunately, the side that you see, the bass side, there is kind of a major one right here. Something dinged the finish up right there. But if you can live with that one, and then the little ding at the top of the headstock. I mean, other than that, you could probably put this on a store shelf and call it new. But let's go ahead and blacklight test it. Looking under blacklight here, I mean, it's 3 years old. Probably hasn't been outside too much. You don't see a lot of a glow, but it kind of looks more like a cherry sunburst finish here. That's cool. This spot on the finish is a little bit interesting, though. It doesn't feel like it's any type of clear coat wear, but it might be. Somebody might anchor their hand right here when they're doing finger picking or something. I couldn't tell that under regular lighting situations, but everything looks good here. Face of the headstock, that's glowing a little bit more. Your truss rod's glowing pretty cool too. And the back of the neck, no breaks, cracks, or repairs. Man, it'd be hard to hide a repair on a natural finish, but hey, this is just for fun. Cool. This instrument comes in a Gibson USA tan hard shell case. Got 1, 2, 3, 4, and a fifth back latch, so everything's good there. You have your handle, and the interior is pink. Now, if you remember, in the Trade Tuesday episode, we were saying that this guitar was ridiculously heavy. And when my wife helped me bring this guitar in, she's like, what is in this case? It's so heavy. And I found out, it's not so much the guitar that's heavy. Yeah, sure, it's almost 10 pounds, but I mean, that's Norlin era status. But it's the case. It's the case that is super heavy. And I find this sometimes. This particular case was made in Costa Rica. Yeah, isn't that great? Your Gibson USA case is made in Costa Rica. I think they're made in Canada today, but there's sometimes when they're Costa Rican made, sometimes, I think it's Taiwan, something like that. But sometimes you'll find these crazy 12.5 pound cases. That's ridiculous. Here's an early 90s Les Paul case in the same style that only weighs 8 pounds 12 ounces. But despite being heavier, it does feel more padded. It's very cushiony. As compared to the 90s case over here, it just doesn't have as nice a foam in it. But I think what really contributes to the weight is the type of wood that they used for the case. It just happened to be heavier. But if you think you might be interested in being the next owner of this zebra-coiled Les Paul traditional lemon top, feel free to check out that link in the description that will take you to the Reverb for Sale page. Thank you, Troglodytes, for watching, and we will see you tomorrow on the next episode. Take care!